Love Is Still a Worthy Cause is born out of one of my favorite stories of this season of our lives. A friend of mine from Minneapolis is a businessman, and he'd had a great experience working with farmers in Rwanda in a partnership. And so he thought, what if we did some sort of poverty reduction model with 12 businessmen from Minneapolis who have all different kinds of experiences, represent all kinds of wealth and education and resources. And so he brought 11 friends and himself, so 12 businessmen from Minneapolis, went to Africa, and their goals were to create something that had longevity, sustainable growth. They were going to find a person of promise, someone who had dreams to become a doctor or become an engineer, but couldn't fulfill that. And they were going to pour their collective influence and knowledge into this person of promise. So they went and looked for 2 weeks for this person of promise, and they saw and met all kinds of people. They met all kinds of incredible potential people of promise. And he said the very last day, the guy that was leading them around said, there's a community very remote that I've not checked in on a long time. We need to go there. And so they all got into this vehicle and drove as far as they could in this vehicle until the jungle became so dense they could go no further. And when they got to the edge of the community, it began to rain, and they had been talking the whole way, very excited, and they couldn't find anybody. And within several minutes, it was clear that all of the adults in this community had died of AIDS, and that all that was left were the children and the very, very elderly. And the children were being led by the 17-year-old girl, and they were just trying to find food however they could, scavenging in the woods and trying to collect things. And he said at this moment, these 12 businessmen immediately became 12 fathers. As the rain began to fall harder and harder and the children scattered to find cover, they were just running around fixing roofs. No one was saying a word. They were just trying to do as much as they could. And he said he doesn't remember who started it, but one of the men took off his coat and wrapped it around a child, and they began to disrobe, literally some of them down to their boxer shorts, just to say physically, what can I give you right now? I just want to help you. And he said immediately we were in love with these children. 12 fathers in love with these kids. And they walked out in silence, some of them literally stripped naked, in the rain, back to the vehicle in silence, got in their vehicle, flew home to the States, you know, the next day. And he said, we gathered around a conference table that next week and knew that our person of promise would be these children possibly infected with HIV/AIDS who have nothing to offer in the sense of going to medical school or becoming engineers or anything went to that extent. When I first heard that story, my heart was so full with this reminder that God still deals with individual people. He doesn't hear mass numbers and those kinds of things. He still deals with individual hearts. And it blew me away that he would send these 12 businessmen all the way around the world to basically find these kids who were lost. And I had ruminated on that for a long time, had written the verses for Love Is Still a Worthy Cause. I thought, what has not been said yet? It hit me like a ton of bricks. In fact, I remember bursting into tears when it dawned on me that I am that girl. I am like those kids. I had nothing to offer. I was not a person of promise. But God goes to great lengths to come find me, to come into my chaos, and to come and walk into my despair, to bring hope to me. And so this becomes the bridge of this song, I Love Because He Loved Me. And that's the motivation of all my acts of generosity are out of this heart that understands completely. He has been so generous to me. I can't help but be generous and to pour out in this way. And that story really helped me balance out, I guess, I'm going to save the world, you know? That's not what God's asking me to do. He's asking me to pay attention to individual people that He brings into my life.